Quick disclaimer before the video begins, if you're here looking for crazy riding or like fast trail riding, you will be severely disappointed. The purpose of these is to track my progress. As of now, my seat time is just over an hour on the trails. So I am absolutely horrible at riding this thing. I don't have much dirt bike riding experience really at all in general. Hopefully in a year from now, I'll be able to look back at videos like this and see just how much I've improved over time. So I'm very aware that my skill level is very low. However, if you do decide to watch and you have any criticisms or any tips and tricks to build my riding skills, I am open ears. Enjoy the video and I will see you guys in the next one. Peace out.
Well guys, this may be my first video on the new channel. This is basically going to be less professional videos and stuff that might not really be related, you know, to the normal builds and stuff that I have on my YouTube channel. So basically, like, what we're doing today is a practice day. I've decided that my dirt bike skills, we already knew this, they suck, dude. My dirt bike skills are literally probably like a 1 out of 10, dude. No joke. So I decided I want to try to ride at least one full hour of seat time a week. If I can do more, we'll do more. But, you know, that's coming from like basically almost no ride time. I usually go riding 2-3 times a year. It's been that way pretty much my whole life. And it's time to... I really just want to build my skill and stuff, man, especially on a dirt bike. I've always wanted to build my skills on a dirt bike. But yeah, so I didn't get this idea myself. This came from Robert Ramosi. Robert's a really good friend of mine. And he was telling me that it might be cool to post these practice rides. And in like a year, I should be a pretty good rider. And it might be cool to look back and see the change in skill level, which hopefully, you know, maybe by then I'll be like a 2 out of 10. But yeah, it's not gonna be anything crazy. I think I'm just gonna ride. But you know, this channel will basically be, you know, stuff like this, these kind of videos, and update videos on, you know, stuff like the Z400 and everything, because the type of videos that I do, they take a lot of work and I can't really make them quickly. A lot of people ask for update videos and stuff. And I like to put kind of more like polished videos on the main channel. So this will be a good spot for that. And then maybe things that aren't related, if anything like that happens, I can put it on there. But yeah, so I'm just gonna ride. Right now, the total hours on the bike are 1.5. So I have like an hour of practice on it so far, because the first half hour was really like riding on the grass, kind of doing the braking and stuff. And I know my main issue, I think anyways, is that I sit too much and I ride with my arms. I barely ever, I naturally do not want to hold the bike with my legs, and I know I need to do that, especially with the twist throttle. I've learned that you lose a lot of control with the twist throttle if you're trying to hold on with your arms, and just arm pump and riding long periods of time, it makes it like impossible doing it that way. It's not the right way to ride. So that's really what I'm going to focus on in the beginning. I've been watching videos on like skill building and stuff. If you guys know any, let me know. Like I saw one where you put paper plates between your knees and the bike, so that like if you're not squeezing the bike, you know, the paper plate's gonna fall out. Stuff like that. always, when I first start riding, I feel like that's when the arm pumps the worst. And then after I'm riding for like 30 minutes or so, and I'm basically talking about quad riding because I don't have that much experience on dirt bikes, but it's like you, I don't know what happens, but the arm pump goes away. Trying to focus on squeezing with my legs. I don't really expect many people to watch this because it's so boring. Really, what I think is going to be cool is like in a year or so when you can go back and look at these and just see like the amount of improvement. Keep like defaulting back to just like monster grip strength. I even used to train grip strength thinking that that's what it was. It was like my grip is just not strong enough, and still like I would die immediately. It's because you just can't just ride with your arms. people that said to stand, like, it really, I can't believe how much my body just naturally wants to sit. Every time, it's like picking at your nails or something. You're trying to like break a habit. The second you're not focusing on it, you're doing it. My freaking forearms, not squeezing with my legs. I'm just holding on for dear life with my hands. I just cannot seem to remember to squeeze this damn bike with my legs. stuff looks like it could be really sticky.
Road, I think so.
trail. Smell that Banshee two-stroke. But on this trail, like, I'm comfortable going faster. Oh shit, holy fuck, that was deep. That was so deep, dude. Oh man, my boots are soaked. Chill just a little bit because I feel like I'm starting to get more comfortable, but I don't want to get, oh shit, I think I just stomped on the rear brake. But exactly like I was just saying, you get too comfortable too quick. You guys got to remember, I'm still a newbie. I have like not even 2 hours of experience on this now. And I'm sure this thing could get away from you. All right, I don't want to go through that super deep part again. That was crazy. It's funny because the first time it felt like it wasn't that deep. And then like that last time was super deep. this bike goes, like how fast it tops out, or its top speed. I would say like maybe 60. Chill out. That was really fun. That was probably the most fun I've had on this yet. That was really fun. What's up, dude? What's up, man? It's a nice Banshee. This thing's clean, man. It's like, did you redo this or is this? I mean, there's like no boot rub or nothing.
So I bought the Banshee from some guy on Instagram out in California, and I think what happened was some guy, he literally needed a 50-cent fucking part to get this thing to run, and he couldn't get it to run. So he sold it to this guy who's like a Banshee broker, I guess you could say. And I guess the type of riding that they were doing was maybe like out in sand dunes or something like that. So like the frame was like intact. The guy's like, dude, this was sitting in a shed for like probably 15, 20 years.
Yeah, it looks beautiful, dude.
Yeah, so I'm like, fuck it, I'll take it. So it was like $7,000 for the bike.
That's what I was gonna ask.
And then after I bought the bike, you know, I put new rims and tires. I put the Nerf bars. I did the axle.
Did you put the Elkas on there?
Yeah, that's what I just did. Yeah, I put the Elka.
You even got the billet hubs and everything, man. Those LSR billet hubs. Did you put those on?
Yeah, I put those on. I ordered those, put those on. When I was a kid, I grew up, you know, riding with my dad when I was like a teenager. Now I'm 35. So I kind of, now I live out here. So I'm like, I want to relive like my fucking, you know, younger years. So I always loved Banshees. And I was like, dude, two stroke fucking, you know, like the sound, everything. I'm like, yeah, I want a Banshee. So it's a fucking fun hobby. You know what I mean? What else are we
gonna... I'm Mike, by the way.
Oh, John. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, man. Cool. He's a local guy. Said he always wanted a Banshee. And now that he's a little bit older, he can finally afford one. Am I stepping on the brake? What am I doing here? I think I'm stepping on the brake. I hope, anyways. What is this? Is that always lighting up? The other thing I noticed, or thought about anyways, is like in all of the years that I rode dirt bikes, which is like very seldomly, I would ride in like 20, 30 minute clips and then chill for like 2 fucking hours. And like, it was just the group I would ride with. Honestly, they would ride for like a really short period of time and then they'd want to smoke. And I don't even smoke, but you know, you do that, it's like you go riding for 5 hours, but you really only rode for like 40 to 60 minutes total. And then we wouldn't ride for like 2-3 months. Like, you will never build skill that way, obviously. I feel like just in this little bit today, I'm already significantly better. Turn it around and go back the other way. I imagine there's tons of trails and stuff here just like that. Out of nowhere. I don't want to go too far though, because I don't know these trails and I can totally see getting lost back here. Everything kind of looks the same. Dude, this thing is so much fun. All right, that's where we came from. This bike is really, really fun. ride. I think we'll get one more in here. It's starting to get kind of chilly. It's going to get dark soon. We're at 2.3 hours, so we're almost at the hour mark for the day. Like doing the uphills. Thank you. think it's because this sand over on this side is a lot softer. Is why I don't feel as confident on it. When I go on those back trails, it's like I feel like I have a lot more traction and the bike isn't sliding around as much. It's a lot more fun. Time. For whatever reason, I feel like I'm losing my confidence a little bit. Just about it for today, guys. I don't know why that is at the end there. It's like I felt like I just lost my confidence a little bit, and I feel like that's usually probably a good time to call it. before I do something stupid, especially it's getting dark here. We got 2.5 hours, so we got the full hour in today. It is probably gonna get dark here pretty soon, so. Whew, man, way more fun than the first time I took it out, I can tell you that much.